Hello and welcome. In this video, we talk about radar technology, its various applications in interior radar sensing, regulatory topics, and much more. We hope this is really helpful to you. Today, we have Brian Ginsberg with us, who is a systems manager at TI Radar Business Group. He's also one of the founding members of the radar chipset and the group within TI. Welcome, Brian.
Thank you, Kishore. I'm glad to be here.
We are seeing a trend in the adoption of radar technology for in-cabin sensing. Can you let us know what are the reasons for it? Why radar?
Radar sensors have the capability to detect the presence of life even under various environmental conditions. They can do this very accurately even under changing temperature or lighting conditions, or whether, for instance, a child is covered by a blanket. Euro NCAP has made this a priority for adoption in new vehicles. And then in the US, while the Senate has tabled the bill that would have addressed heat strokes in children and unattended vehicles, the OEMs have actually committed to voluntarily adopting this technology.
It's great to know that radar is capable of solving vision sensing challenges. And you mentioned about child presence detection. I think it's a great way to solve a safety problem. What are the other applications which radar technology can solve?
Sure, radar has a lot of different applications in the car. It has the ability to detect not only the presence of people, it can detect their positions through its ability to resolve in both range and angle. And it can also do things like detecting the size of the object, distinguishing between a child and an adult, as well as being able to classify between an inanimate object and a living being. And you can use this, for instance, to do sophisticated seatbelt reminders or as part of the deployment of the airbags. There's been demonstrations of radar technology to measure vital signs, like the human respiration and heart rate. This could be used as part of a driver monitoring system in fatigue detection. And then finally, there's some other applications like gesture, where the radar can be used to detect swipes or maybe finger twirls. And this can be used to interact with your dashboard and control things like lighting or radio in a vehicle.
For viewers out there, please check out our TI Resource Explorer, millimeter wave toolbox. We have a lot of reference software examples and TI designs, which can showcase how to start your design to solve these applications. Brian, what is the frequency band of operation which is allowed for such applications inside a car?
So we see that the 60 gigahertz band has been adopted by tier ones and OEMs globally for this use case. There's different regulations in terms of the output power and the available bandwidth in different regions of the world. And we know that our customers are doing their own investigations with the local regulatory authorities for their particular use cases.
Can you talk about different regions, for example, Europe and Korea maybe?
So we see that the 60 gigahertz band is being adopted by many tier ones and OEMs throughout the world. And the actual output power and bandwidth may vary according to region. In Europe, this is classified as a short-range device and is currently allowed, and we also see it's widely embraced in areas like Korea and Japan.
Can you talk a little bit more about the North American region in particular? We hear that the sensor could be used as a field disturbance sensor or a interactive motion sensor. Can you tell us a little bit more on when exactly each one of that is applicable?
So in the U.S., the 60 gigahertz band is regulated under Part 15 of the FCC code. And their radars are considered field disturbance sensors. And there's two specific use cases that are allowed. One is for fixed operation. And this, we think, can occur while the car is stationary, not moving. And there's also allowed for interactive motion sensing, which is defined as the short-range hand gesture detection scenarios. And these both can be allowed under wide bandwidths at very low output powers. And for the fixed operation, you can also operate over narrow bandwidth at high output powers. There's been a lot of action about this in terms of proposals for changing the regulations, as well as various customers have been applying for waivers, and this is an ongoing process.
If there are multiple such sensors inside the car, do you see a potential for interference among them? Or if there is an external communication device such as WiGig, could there be interference?
So the AWR68 sensors actually have integrated hardware features that allow them to synchronize over the car vehicle network, and this will completely eliminate any mutual interference between the different radar sensors in the vehicle. And when it comes to external interference, they have a number of features to both detect and then ultimately mitigate interference, whether it's from a different radar or from a communication system.
For tier ones and developers, what are the key care abouts when they start the development of in-cabin sensors?
there's a lot of steps that are required in this, and it's actually similar to some of the sensor development that you'd have for, let's say, an ADAS sensor at 77 gigahertz. The first thing to do is to identify where in the vehicle you want this to be mounted, and then ultimately develop, start with the PCB and design an antenna that can adapt to the field of view, or use our version that has the antenna in package or that is already integrated. The next step would be to start working on the module housing. At this point, they also need to include the design of the radome, which is required for the optimum performance between the antennas and the rest of the vehicle. And then finally, as you continue on the hardware side of the development, you'll need to go through and make sure that it meets all of the regulatory certification wherever you wanted to have it deployed. For each of these steps, we have application notes to help guide you along the way. On the software side, TI offers a software development kit with all the drivers and libraries. In addition, we have a number of reference designs, including one for child presence detection, to jumpstart the application development.
And all of these come free of cost?
All of our references and application notes are all on our web, with many of the examples in the TI Resource Explorer.
Thank you, Brian. With this, we come to the end of this video. We hope it was really helpful to you, and you can start your design with the Texas Instruments 60 GHz AWR-6X sensors. TI AWR-6X sensors are the most versatile, highly integrated, and scalable sensors out there in the market, and we have made it a point to make the development process much simpler and easier. Thank you for watching the video.